Good morning, students. Welcome again. We entered into a very important topic, that is recording the transactions into journal entries. The very basic of accounting is conversion of accounting transaction into journal entry. Once journal entry is passed properly, then posting will be easy. Then updation of trial balance, it's make automatic, and later final accounts will tally. We won't get any tension when we prepared and tallied the balance sheet. It automatically get tallied. So important is to properly convert the transaction into journal entry. If we did any mistake in conversion of transaction into journal entry, the effect is in next levels: ledger account, trial balance, profit and loss account, balance sheet. So that's why we have to understand well the types of accounts and the rules of accounts. If we had thorough knowledge about types of accounts, there were no large number of types or many types are there. Only three types. Accounts are how many types? Three types. What are they? Personal, real, nominal. Rules also very simple, but we were not so keen to remember those things. Even people, those who are completed intermediate, pass many journal entries, and they don't understand when to debit cash, when to credit cash, when to debit sales, sales are debit or credit. Still they had dilemma. When the party name was given, whether to record party name or not. When the party name and cash was given, dilemma what to be right. Okay, that's why students, you please understand the types of accounts as well as rules, as well as how to prepare journal entries if the transaction was given to us. Okay, syllabus, you know, we are at last point, that is journal. Ledger and trial balance we will do later. Okay, important concepts which we are going again are types of accounts. How many types of accounts are there? Three types. What are they? Personal, real, nominal. The rules of accounts. Rules are different from one account to the other account. Personal account rules are debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. Nominal account rules are all expenses and losses debit, all incomes and gains credit. Later, remembering the accounts, identifying the type of the account, applying a rule and debit what to be, what account to be debited and what account to be credited. That is very important. Students. So, if you are perfect in stage 1, remaining stages, ledger account, trial balance will be easy. The basics of accounts are identification of accounts, knowing the type of the accounts, applying a clear rule or a particular rule to that particular account, and debiting and crediting the account is very, very, very important. Very important. Again, we will discuss about, okay, the process of accounting starts with the events that we are calling it as transactions. Accountant will look at the transaction or analyze the transaction, convert the journal entry, convert the transaction into journal entry, and record that journal entry in original book book of original entry is called day book. He will record in the day book. Later he will post into ledger account. Later he will update the balance, ledger balance in trial balance. Next stage he will prepare financial statements and submit it to the users. The first user of financial statements are owners of the organization. Okay, that is, this process helps in decision making. This process helps in decision making. Okay, right. Types of accounts, three types: personal, real, nominal. Please remember this slide in your mind. Personal, real and nominal. Okay, then the rules of personal accounts are related to persons or individuals, natural persons, artificial persons, representative persons. Natural persons are like us, artificial persons are your college, bank, company. Representative persons are outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses like that. Second type of account is the real account, that is related to property, position or liability. Real account may be recorded for two types, that is tangible real account and intangible real account. Tangible means which we can see. And a very important one is nominal account. All the expenses, incomes, gains and losses of an organization were recorded in under the nominal account type. Okay, so rules of the accounts: debit the receiver, credit the giver. Which type of accounts rules? Personal accounts rules. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Which type of account rules? Real account rules. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Which type of account rules? Nominal account rules. So what are the personal account rules? If the in the transaction, if name of a person is there, suppose he is receiving benefit, his account is debited. In a transaction, name of the person is there, suppose he is a giver, then his account, his name, his account name will be credited. Okay, so the personal account rules are debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account rules are debit what comes in, credit what goes out. And nominal account rules are debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Students, please remember this slide also. Again, same rules were mentioned in this table format. Debit the receiver, credit the giver, personal account. What comes in, what goes out, real account. All expenses and losses, debit. All incomes and gains, credit. That is nominal account. Okay, again explanation was given regarding personal account, real account and nominal account. Okay, now we will pass journal entries. Before that, journal is nothing but a book of original entry. Book of original entry. That we are calling it as a day book. Original means first we are entering the transaction in the form of journal entry in that book. That's why it is called as a book of original entry, which is called as day book. A journal is a record of all the transactions of a company. Journal is a record of all the transactions of a company as recorded. It is a record. Okay, whether you know or I don't know. Okay, I saw in an organization, day book is this much of size. So all the journal entries of the company are recorded in that day. Okay, that's why it is called as book of original entry. A journal stores a complete record of every business transaction that company makes. Okay, a journal stores, journal is nothing but a day book, which is the record of all the company transactions. Record stores the all records of or all transactions of a company that makes. This usually include transaction date, description is called as narration, accounts were affected. How many accounts we will write in journal entry? Two accounts. One is debit account, another one is a credit account, as well as debits and credits. Journal is a chronological record of the transactions. We had an experience writing in intermediate. Okay, January 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, like that. So in a chronological order, we will pass journal entries or we will record company transactions consist of debit and credit. Okay. Journalizing is an activity. Passing the journal entries is an activity that is called a journal entry. Journalizing. Journal entry is analysis of all the effects of single transaction on various accounts, usually accompanied by an explanation. The students, earlier video also I explained how to pass journal entries. Look here. It is an explanation or analysis. The transaction received cash from Ram is analyzed. While analyzing, I came to know there are two accounts. One is cash account, another one is Ram account. Later, I identified that cash account is real type account and Ram account is personal type account. I applied the rules. Real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit, and according to the transaction, cash received from Ram, cash is coming into business. That's why I applied only rule what comes in. If I applied what comes in, then automatically account will become debit. That's why cash account data I wrote. Ram is personal. I applied a rule giver and receiver. Here Ram is giver. I took only the rule giver. That's why his account is credited. So why wrote record Ram account with two is nothing but a credit. Okay. So journal entry is a analysis of all the effects of a single transaction and on the various accounts, usually accompanied by an explanation. So a compound entry means that single transaction affects more than two accounts. We will add this compound entries in near future. When there are more than one debit and credits are there, that entry is called as a compound entry. Okay, students. Format of journal entry, I already explained. Then style of journal entry, already explained. First we have to write debit. Then later we have to write credit. And we should not use any shortcuts. And we should not use any currency symbols. One line should have to be left between each entry. And entry should not split between the pages. Okay. So there are three steps are there. While passing the journal entry, there are three steps are there. One is classify the transaction into accounts. Or classify the business transaction by accounts. In that business transaction, how many accounts are affected? Later, find out the types of those accounts, affected accounts. Later, apply the rule of particular type of account. Rules, two rules are there, but we have to apply only one rule according to the transaction. Okay, students, how many steps are there while passing journal entry? Three steps. One is identify the accounts. Second one is knowing their type. Third one is applying the rule to debit or credit. With these steps, we did one problem also, problem number 13 from your textbook. Okay, now we will do problem number 14. Problem number 14. Okay, I am closing this PPT and I will come. Right, students, look at this journal entries procedure, how I passed, transaction, accounts, type, and rules, journal entry. Next one is a journal entry. Okay. Just a minute, okay? Just for understanding purpose, you know, I'm making some arrangements. Right. So look at the problem number 14. Number 1, 2, 3 are the transactions. 1, 2, 3 are transactions. Right. Transaction 14th one. Transactions of, look at PPT. Okay. Transactions of Ramesh for April 2016 are given in below. Generalize them. So I am writing journal entries in the books of journal entries. Please note down everybody in your notebook. In the books of Ramesh. Okay. Transaction. One. In the, what is the transaction one? 2016 April 1st. Ramesh started business with cash. So, first one is a cash account is there and he started business means he invested in the business is nothing but a capital. Capital. Ramesh, sorry, cash is which type of account? Real account, because it is asset. Real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. Real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. So whenever Ramesh started business, he cash is coming into Ramesh business. Cash is coming into Ramesh business. So in the business, cash is coming in. That's why I have to apply the rule. What comes in? What comes in? So what comes in should be debit or not? What comes in should be debit. Then cash account, account data. Cash account data. Then another one is capital account. Okay. Capital is personal account. Ramesh capital name, personal account. Ramesh is giver. Personal account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. Ramesh gave money to business. That's why the giver, Ramesh is the giver. Giver should be credited. That's why it is to Ramesh capital or to capital account. Amounts we will write later, okay? Next 15th problem we will write. Then coming to the next entry. Next entry. Paid into bank. What we paid? Cash. When we deposited into bank, what we are depositing? Cash. One is cash. Where we deposited? In the bank account. Bank. So cash is also, cash is asset. Assets are recorded under real account. Bank also asset are recorded in under real account. When I deposited cash, cash is going out. So real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. Real account rules are what comes in debit, what goes out credit. So cash is going out. That's why I have to apply rule what goes out. What goes out? What goes out should be credit. Then where I am depositing? Bank. Bank is getting benefited. In the bank, okay, it is coming in. What comes in? What comes in will be debit. So which account to be write first? Debit account. That's why bank account data. Bank account data to cash account. To cash account. Okay, students. So that is the procedure. Whenever next time onwards, we won't write this analysis. Next time onwards, we won't write this analysis. Simply, we will pass general entry, keeping in our mind. Keeping in our mind. Okay. So for understanding purpose only, I am passing this general entry. Right, next number 3. Third one. Bought goods for cash. What we bought goods. Goods bought or goods purchases is comes under purchases. Is nothing but goods. Understanding purpose. Every next time onwards, whenever goods are there, directly we can write purchases as well as sales. Goods are asset is nothing but a real account. Cash is which type? Tell me. Real account. So tell me, when I purchased goods, I paid cash. Cash is going out or coming in? Going out. So the rule I have to apply here for cash real account type is what goes out. What goes out? Be credited. When I purchased goods, goods are coming in or not, then what comes in will be debit. What comes in? Debit. And the entry will be always purchases account data to cash account. Purchases account data to cash account. Students, remember, purchases always debit. Because we are getting goods. Sales always credit. Because goods are going out. Goods are going out. Right. Next entry. Hope you are following me, I think. I hope you are following me. Right. Next. Due cash from bank for office use. Due cash from bank for office use. So what I drawn? Cash. From where I drawn? Bank. Look at the second entry. Cash is which type of account? Real. Bank is which type of account? Real. Because it represents assets. When I withdrawn cash from bank for office use and the amount is coming into office, what comes in debit? What comes in debit? So from the bank cash is going out, what goes out? What goes out? Credit. Then automatically the entry, we have to write first debit na? That's why cash account data. To bank account. We'll write amount also, okay? Cash account data to bank account, amount is 0100. Narration also will write. No worries, okay? We'll write later. Entry number 4 is completed. Note down, please. Next. He asked us to leave one line between one journal entry to another journal entry. Now that's why we are leaving gap. Right. Sold goods to Krishna on credit. What we sold? Goods. We are calling them as sales. For understanding purpose, we will write goods. And to whom it was sold? Krishna. We have to write his name. Goods are always real account. Krishna is which type of account? Personal account. And when I sold the goods, goods are coming in or going out? Going out. That's why what goes out is credit. Remember students, sales are always credit. Krishna is personal account. Personal account rules are debit the receiver, credit the giver. So, goods are received by Krishna, that's why receiver. The receiver will be debited. So, entry will be Krishna account data. Krishna account data to sales account. In the sense, why sales are credited? Because goods are going out. Why purchases are debited? Because goods are coming in. Goods are coming in. Okay, students. I hope you are following. Just understanding purpose only, I am writing transactions, transaction number, accounts, types of accounts, rules. Okay, so remaining 20, day 20, 24, 28, 30, You practice, okay? When our WhatsApp group is there, then you try to make a note. Whether you are correct or not, I will share the answer also. Okay, students? Right. Bye. Okay. So 24 and 25 date number April 20, 24, 28, 30. You practice at home and check with your answers with my answer. Okay. Bye students. Don't forget to subscribe to getting the updates, updated videos.